Welcome to the video cast of OpenYarn. In this video cast, we are going to take a real-time scenario and then try to model it and implement it using C programming language. And today's puzzle is apple farm, and there is a farmer, and we are going to help him to harvest the apple. Here you see owner of the farm, and we have set of workers. On the day of harvest, the farmer will come to the owner will come to the farm, and then he will, based on the number of apples in the tree, he will employ set of workers. And there are two functionalities in harvesting the apple. The first functionality is he will assign or employ a set of workers who will climb the tree, and they will pluck the apple and they will put into a common container. And he will also employ another set of workers, right, who will get the apple from the container, and they will clean it, and then they will package it and send it to the market for selling. And this is a real-time scenario, and for this we need to come up with a design and then solve it using C programming language. And when you are trying to do that, first you have to understand the problem. And if you are not, if at this point of time, if you are not clear about the problem, I would suggest you to hear the video from the first, understand the problem, and list down the components. For example, here we have a lot of components in this problem. So list down the components, and you should also list down the functionality of each component, and come up with a design how you will put together these components to make it as a big solution, right? And identify important data structures, because since you are going to implement it using software, you need to identify important data structures. The data structure can be simple, or the data structure can be little complex, right? And then for each component, they have specific functionality, and you have to identify the list of algorithms using which these components will work together and bring out a bigger functionality. And at the end, you have to check the completeness of your solution. You have to check the completeness of your design. Once you have done with that, you can go ahead and do this as a program. We have seen various entities in this puzzle. We have a farm, and farm has owner, right? And then a farm have collection of trees, and each tree will have an apple, and we have set of workers who will perform the job, right? We have to model this same thing in C programming language. And first, let's see an example of how it is, how we can come up with a structure for farm. A farm will have collection of entities. The farm will have an owner. Each farm will have only one owner. And then a farm will have a set of workers, right? So for this puzzle, we have taken that number of workers be 30, right? And the farm will have a collection of trees. Again, we have assumed that there are around 100 trees in the farm. And each farm will have a container where we will collect all the apples from the tree, and we will put it in the common container and then send it to the different destination, right? And here we have two set of structure again. One is for the container and another one for a tree. And a container has a data structure to store around 300 apples. And we have also defined tree that will have up to 25 apples, right? And this is on the data structure side. And still there are a few more data structures or structure definition that you need to come up with. I think we have to define a structure for owner, and we need to define structure for workers, which I would like to leave to you as an exercise. And next is on the implementation, and you have to do your own implementation. But I would like to give a couple of implementation note, right? So if you look at the owner, owner is the primary person who will configure the entire program, right? He will decide the number of workers, and he will also say how many number of people will go and get the apple from the tree, and we will also decide number of people who will package the apples, right? And then workers, they will climb the tree, get the apple, and put in the common container, right? And they will not be putting, they will be in rest if the container is full. The set of workers who will get apple from the tree, they will take rest if the container is full. Similarly, we will have another set of workers who will get the apple from the container and they will package it. They will take rest if the container is empty. These two criteria or the condition has to be met, right? And then we have a common container which kind of act as a common place of storing the apples, right? And we will terminate the program when there are no more apples in the tree and when there are no more apples in the container, right? So I think with this detail, I'm sure that you will be able to write your own program to solve this puzzle.